Hi, I'm Graeme Steele, CEO and founder of Cryptosense, and today I'm going to talk about the third NIST PQC Standardization Conference and what happened there. So this conference happened 3 weeks ago now on the 7th to the 9th of June 2021, and just a reminder about where this is in the process, this is the third conference of this kind. The NIST conferences on post-quantum crypto standardization started back in 2015. The candidates were submitted in 2017. Last year we had the finalists announced, so there's seven finalists and eight alternate candidates, and this conference was supposed to update us and find out where we are we any closer to actually getting a winner. So it was a pretty long conference. You can watch all of the videos and see all the transcripts and so on online, and there'll be links in the description of the video. I'm just going to tell you about three key points that will probably be of interest if you're following the post-quantum crypto standardization for your organization that came out of this conference. So the first point is there's no winner yet. So they didn't announce that any of the candidates have been definitively selected for standardization. But remember, we're expecting to have a whole bunch of winners in the post-quantum crypto standardization process because all the algorithms have different trade-offs in terms of key size and ciphertext size and execution time and so on. So we're expecting several of these to go through. Some people thought that maybe at least some of these selected candidates might be announced, but they weren't this time. So we're now expecting the decision to be at the end of the year or very early in 2022, how NIST put it. At that point, we'll know who the winners are, but in fact, that will only be the first set. So there will continue to be a fourth round of standardization that's expected to go on for another 12 to 18 months afterwards. There's going to be a call for new candidates, even in digital signatures, to see if we can get some other characteristics nailed, so things for resource-constrained devices and so on. And then after we get these selected candidates, NIST expect to do at least a year of work to create the standardized version, so actually write those standards. And then those standards will go out for public review. So now we're into 2023, and it'll probably be 2024 before we have the fixed standard that you can actually go ahead and use. So an update to the timeline then. The other thing that was announced was that, surprise to nobody, that there will definitely be selected winners that are based on lattice-based cryptography. So this is pretty much what everybody expected. It's one of the most mature areas of cryptography that looks to be quantum resistant and has a whole bunch of cryptanalysis on it. And there were the most candidates submitted in that category right at the beginning of the competition. But what NIST are proposing is to only standardize one lattice-based scheme for encryption, so for key establishment, and one lattice-based scheme for signature. So this is a little bit more controversial because there's several reasons why you might want to have different selected winners in this competition. One is that you want to make different trade-offs in terms of ciphertext size and speed and all these other things. The other is that you might want to use different hardness assumptions, so different kinds of mathematics, because we actually don't know in the future whether, when there is a large quantum computer, somebody might come up with a really smart algorithm that, for example, breaks lattice-based cryptography. So we might need to move to something else. So there are these two competing reasons. So if we look at the two candidates that are left, lattice-based candidates that are left in the signature competition, so these are called Dilithium and Falcon. So these are both lattice-based schemes, but they have very different characteristics. So to summarize, you could say that Falcon has much smaller ciphertext size, which can be really important for some applications, but it requires a more difficult implementation because you have to do Gaussian sampling and not just sampling from a uniform distribution. And if you get that slightly wrong, you might lose a lot of security. So in fact, you've got two very different candidates there, and there might be arguments, and this was debated at the conference, to maybe standardize both of them, or at least talk about this a bit more before we go ahead and select just one of them. So that's point two. The third point is that NIST have updated their standard for key establishment for having, this is the document that you have to be in compliance with if you want to get a FIP certificate on your cryptography. And using key establishment to allow the use of hybrid methods. That is to say, you can establish your key using one already NIST approved method and mix in the input from a not yet approved, for example, post-quantum crypto candidate. So this is a very important thing because a lot of people who are worried about the fact that the data that they're establishing keys for now has to be stored and might be attacked in the future by somebody with a quantum computer, want to already mix in some of these PQC algorithms to their key establishment to give them a greater deal of security on that in the future. But before, if you did this, you could lose your NIST compliance, and this can be a very big deal. But now NIST have updated that, so you can still be FIPS compliant even if you're doing this hybrid key establishment. So that's the three big takeaways from the conference. Other than that, there was a really interesting talk by the Department of Homeland Security talking about how they are not going to implement any post-quantum cryptography until after the standardization process is finished. And at the moment, they're just going to content themselves with doing a really good crypto inventory of all the cryptography they're using, because they don't want to have to migrate twice. And the point of this is that migrating to a post-quantum algorithm isn't just a question of switching in a library. You actually have to make changes all over the place in how your application works, how your procedures work, and so on, depending on which candidate you choose. And if those candidates change, then you might have wasted all that work. And we saw in the conference there have been recent advances in cryptanalysis, for example, in multivariate cryptography that really affects some of the candidates in the competition. And so it may be that new advances come along and change those candidates in the part of the standardization process that's still left to run. So if you want to work on a crypto inventory for your organization, Cryptosense makes the best tools on the market for doing this. You can find out more about that in the comments. Otherwise, subscribe here to the Cryptosense YouTube channel to stay up to date with applied crypto news, and I'll see you again soon here for another video.